giving all praises and glories to
Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai Bashem, Rakakodash.
Double honors to our apostles and elders, the great millstone where we learned this truth from, this beautiful truth, this great truth, and to know that we're the end times. But double honors to our apostles and elders, and peace and mercy to the hopeful elect that is preaching his word to all four corners of the earth. This is the day that we're going to preach the day of the Lord Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, the brother. Always coins and said, these are the two most important names you'll ever know in your whole entire life. Right. This is the time that you need to know the Lord.
Woo!
Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai.
That's right.
Because they're bringing judgment, and they're bringing pain, and they're always bringing salvation.
That's right.
So guess what? We're going to talk about you brothers, you two-thirds, man, because two-thirds, you brothers, you people are gone. Yeah. Completely lost in the sauce, not knowing what time is what you're living in. You know, the things happening on the earth, it's for you to understand. Hey, give me Jeremiah. Start at Jeremiah 37. Because it, at last, bro. At last.
Get that word.
I got Jeremiah 37. Start at the fourth verse, bro.
This is Jeremiah 30 and verse 4. And these are the words that the Lord spake concerning Israel and concerning Judah. For thus saith the Lord, we have heard a voice of trembling, of fear, and not of peace.
Don't you hear the words of the Lord? The Lord said there's a voice of trembling and a voice of fear. Don't you see the tremblings? People's minds are mentally gone. They're gone.
Yep, bugging out.
They're bugging out. They don't know what to do, where to turn.
They're perplexed.
Hey, and yeah, the beautiful thing, my woman said, she came home distressed. I said, what's wrong with you? She said, I'm perplexed. Yeah, I was like,
thou sayest.
Hey, so we are in the most greatest times ever, because these are the Lord telling you, I'm coming.
That's right.
The Lord is here. He's doing all things on the earth. Famine, pestilence, plagues, civil war, trains being taken over. Because the vile eviction of the earth is here. Because he's allowing it to happen. Destruction.
So ain't no his football career was long done. He could have been out here on the highways and hedges.
No,
you know, but he told El Yashawamba that this truth was too hateful.
Wow. Hey, and that's bugged the fuck out. Yeah, 3 days right before they found his ass with some water on him.
Yeah,
should have got the real water, right? Right. And then what they did to our Lord and Savior Yahweh Shai, an innocent man was hateful, motherfucker.
Mm-hmm.
So what he did for our nation, our people don't understand that.
Maybe first
that he innocently was bruised. He was whipped. He was tortured, man.
Yep.
But a nigga is too hateful. But what they did to our Lord is fucking hateful. Yep. What they did to our nation was hateful. But a nigga don't want to come in because too damn hateful, man. Yep. But it said, be not offended at me. He was offended at the Lord. Lord took his spirit back.
That's right. Yep.
So go ahead.
Let me get this real quick. Because, hey, 1 Peter 4 and 17 says the time is come.
Hey, I get that to a brother.
Yeah, yeah, I was going to say, yeah. What is that?
You want me to
continue on that.
All right, continuing back in Jeremiah 30 and 6. Ask ye now and see whether a man doth travail with child. Wherefore do I see every man with his hands on his loins as a woman in travail, and all faces are turned into paleness.
Because they're in trouble. They're perplexed. They don't know. They don't know that this is the Lord bringing it. But like the brother said, we're in the best place, period. We're in the best time ever to understand the words of the Lord, and we learned it from the greatest men on the planet that he set up.
Yep.
Men, you know?
Hey, it said that their faces is waxing pale, means feeble and weak.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But the Lord said that he was going to make our face hard against even our own people's face. Then he said he was going to make us a brazen wall in the land against the enemy, man. Like, they ain't gonna be able to come up against you unless you too afraid to go out there. Then I'll confound you before them. But if you brave, the Lord gave us not the spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. That's what keeps us out here.
That's
That's the spirit, bro.
Okay, keep going.
Verse 7. Alas, for that day is great, so that none is like it. It is even the time of Jacob's trouble.
When you go into that word at last, it means unfortunate. Unfortunate. He told you twice, unfortunate, unfortunate. You know, continue.
It says, but he shall be saved out of it.
We're in the time of, this is the worst time ever. That you're ever going to go through your life. But guess what? With this time, right, this end will bring us to a new end, a new era.
A new beginning.
For us, that we're not struggling, that we're not in pain, we're not in turmoil, but we're the Lord's children.
That's right.
Hey, but yet Jake still walked by, and that's why the Lord said, pray not for this people. Hey,
that's right.
Seeing it in Buffalo. With you ugly, black-ass, cricket, fucking roach niggas, man.
That's right.
You don't want the truth. You don't want to be free.
Yep.
So the Lord said, you are on the breach ready to fall. Your ass, love oppression. And this devil going to come down. He going to show you the real Edomite side of him, man. As the Elder Ariala said, man, he going to show you the real Esau. That he don't fucking like you niggas, man. Go ahead,
huh? That was it. Could, give me Peter. Yeah, first.
This Peter. First Peter 4, and I'm going to start at 15. Is that okay?
Yeah.
1 Peter 4 and 15, but let none of you suffer as a murderer, woo, or as a thief, or as an evildoer.
Hey, and a lot of you niggas that's in the prisons a lot, bro. You niggas deserve to be in there, you fucking piece of skull, you piece of shit.
Yep,
you
that's right.
In a bad state, you a fucking bum on the street. You deserve that, because a lot of you, like last week, proud ass fucking Jake poor and shit. Lord proud, said, man. I hate a poor man that's proud. The fuck you proud about?
Yep.
Lord said, pride wasn't even made for man. But it's on fucking women, ugly ass children, niggas, Esau, the main nigga. So the Lord's like, what the fuck? Hey, fuck you niggas, man. Death
that's
is
right, man.
You niggas are suffering as evildoers.
Yep.
But we're not doing evil.
Yep.
So the Lord's gonna have us have a victory, man.
And look at Mary and Barbara, that whole man. Situation. Man. For your body not to be found to 3 days after, that's hateful. The Lord hated you, man, because that's a disgrace. If your body rot and it's not buried, man.
That was what they said. They said they can tell how long you've been dead by the rate of your body decomposed.
It probably stunk, you know.
It was just in the water in his tub, shower just hit.
Ain't nobody give a fuck about him, you know. That shows that nobody gave a fuck about you, man. The way it took 3 days, man.
Yeah, he was in the water, but not in the water.
Yeah, that's
cool.
This 1 Peter 4 and 15, but let none of you suffer as a murderer,
woo,
or as a thief,
woo,
or as an evildoer,
man,
or as a busybody in other men's matters.
Man, hey, the thing is, you ain't supposed to go into another. Hey, if a man's beating on his wife, he's beating on his wife for a purpose.
That's his business.
Woo! Ain't it beautiful?
And the thing is, hey, you women about to go back to your natural order.
That's right.
You women about to go back to your natural order because, hey, a man is going to have to save you in these last days.
That's right. That's right.
A real man.
That's right.
A real man that loved your halabashi man was shot.
That's right.
Hey, and if I could say real quick, hey, that scripture describes two-thirds because they all up in Esau business. That's why they worshiping them. That's why they trying to bow the knee and conform to his way of life. That's why you'll see a nigga in a suit with a clean, shaved face. Hey, that's the way of this devil. That's not for you.
That's right. And then the brother said, if a man beating his wife, that's his business. And the nigga get offended at that. But then the bitch will say, you ain't shit, you could die. Nigga rap about a nigga dying and shit, and there's no problem, man. You know?
Hypocrisy.
Right? You know? That shows you that you people are fucking all, like you said, worshiping Esau. Y'all are so fucking backwards, man.
And they in every two-thirds or in every other nation's business, but their business, which is this.
Right.
This is for you. These scriptures is for your benefit. You benefit from obeying the words of Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai, right?
That's right. Niggas pro-Ukraine, though. You know?
They don't even know fucking where Ukraine is on the fucking map.
Right.
Niggas, man.
Yet, if any man suffer as a Christian, let him not be ashamed.
Hey, what is the word Christian? It goes back to following Hamashiach, his ways, knowing what he desires. Knowing what, hey, he don't desire this place. He desires this place to be destroyed. And he desires us to walk in him in all matters of the way. He's a girl if he runs with a man.
Yep.
Fuck being a goddamn bitch. Yep. A woman walking down the street, not knowing where the hell to go. That's exactly what these men are. They don't know what town they living in. Yep. That's why I call them the two-headed bitches.
Yep. Yep. Hey, these people in them so-called Christian churches, they not living like Yahweh Shai.
Yeah.
They not being, you know, they not doing the things that Yahweh Shai did when he was on the earth.
That's right.
You know, serving their brethren.
Yep.
You know, being righteous.
Yep. And that video with IUIC that came out recently shows you that them Christian pastors don't be doing nothing that the Lord did. He was trying to fight the niggas at IUIC, man. You know, why are you trying to get carnal if you truly, you know, following after the Lord?
His word was stirring up that demon.
Yeah.
That's why.
He had 2-3 dyke bitches holding him back and shit. Why is it dykes in your church, man? You know, so many unanswered questions.
See, that's not being, you know, like the brothers was going into that word Christian, Christ-like. So you got to be like the anointed one. You got to be, try your best to be, live like Yahweh Shai.
Right.
That's what we're trying to do to the best of our ability.
Yep, and not be ashamed of it, man. A lot of niggas are ashamed of it. We ain't ashamed. You know, we don't give a fuck how you people feel. So
bro, that's the reason why the Most High really killed Mary Baron the way he did. Because he sent him to a man of the Lord, and the Lord had patience with him.
Mm-hmm.
Broke it down to him.
Mm-hmm.
But you offended in the world. Wow. That's why the Lord got you down there for 3 days not knowing. But guess what?
Nobody
you did. Had the word twice. And you still didn't receive it.
Yep.
Go ahead. Prophet Isaiah chapter 51. Jump to verse 4. It says, "Hearken unto me, my people, and give ear unto me, O my nation. For a law shall proceed from me, and I will make my judgment to rest for a light of the people."
Woo!
Judgment. Hey, we have the light, and we tell you the judgment.
Yep.
Hey.
Hey, the light is Yahweh Shai.
That's right.
And he's bringing judgment before judgment and more judgment before that, after that, resurrection.
Yep,
so Lord's willing, we're doing it to the best of our ability, man.
Right.
But this is what we've commanded to do every damn day of our life.
Yep.
Is to follow Yahweh Shai.
That's right.
Verse 5, it says, "My righteousness is near. My salvation is gone forth."
Where is this righteousness at? On the earth. The men of the Lord. And there's only one group that's teaching the real doctrine.
That's right.
Only one doctrine on earth.
Yeah.
It's the men of great millstone.
That's right.
Our apostles and elders. That's why they get double honors. And that's, hey, the water to those great men.
That's right.
Their order, well, they were set up in order. And guess what? Order has been set in front of you.
That's right.
The righteousness is in front of you, but you can't receive it.
And niggas talking about no miracles. This is a miracle.
That's right.
In the time we living in, we still bringing out the word. We feeding our people, man. Miracle, man.
Yep.
So death and destruction to you niggas in these other camps, man. Because y'all don't believe, and that's what the Lord hates us. Oh, faithless generation.
Yep.
How long will the Lord be with you niggas, man?
Yep.
But we're like that new generation that went in there with Joshua and Caleb, man. We seen it. We read about it. We believe that those things happened, and we believe that better things, greater things are going to happen in these times,
that's right,
man.
That's right.
Go ahead, Ak.
Which one you want to?
Are you still reading it?
Oh,
never still reading.
It says, "And my arm shall judge the people."
Woo!
"For the isles shall wait upon me."
Now, what's the Lord's arm?
Yahweh Shai.
No, his right hand is Yahweh Shai. His arm is the heavenly host.
Dang.
That's how the Lord going to judge this world. The Lord going to come with the armada, like Jude said. That's his brother of Yahweh Shai. So he going to come with 10,000 of his saints that was spoken by Enoch. The 7 from Adam. He said the Lord going to come with an army, man, an armada. One angel could destroy the whole planet by himself. The Lord going to come with legions of angels, man.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Ak.
It says, "And on my arm shall they trust."
The chariots, man. We gonna look. The chariots, look up. "For thy salvation draw nigh." The scripture say, "He'll come with healing in his
people."
Woo! That's it. Go ahead,
It says, "Lift up your eyes to the heavens."
Woo!
"And look upon the earth beneath. For the heavens shall vanish away like smoke."
Woo!
This heaven.
That's right.
This heaven is gonna be burnt up with smoke.
That's
and
right.
fire.
Ooh,
this, and this is the hey, this has to happen.
That's right.
For the real kingdom to reign forever.
That's right.
The real kingdom.
Hey, welcome to the world of the real. That's when it's going to get real, man.
That's right.
That's when the fun going to start.
That's right.
That's it.
It says, and the earth shall wax old like a garment. Woo. And they that dwell therein shall die. Woo. In the like manner. But my salvation shall be forever, and my righteousness shall not be abolished.
Hey, Doc, there's a precept to that, brother, don't bring out.
You know, that's the reason. Hey, judgment's coming, so righteousness can be reigned forever. Don't you want that? Woo. 29, Proverbs 29 and 2.
Amen.
Right?
Right.
The earth mourning, I mean the people mourning, because they're not in, somebody grabbed that, bro.
I got righteous authority.
Yeah, Joyce.
Yeah.
Right. So, hey, this has to happen.
That's right.
That's why the Lord put the Spirit on us to come out here boldly and proclaim His name to tell you people that the judgment is coming.
That's right.
I got it. You know, go ahead, huh?
This is Proverbs 29 and 2. When the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice.
Hey, you're not rejoicing now because we're not in right. We're not in the kingdom.
That's right, man.
Right? Go ahead.
But when the wicked beareth rule, the people mourn.
Everyone is mourning. Everyone is in perplexed. Everyone's bugged out, not knowing what a return. But hey, the Lord is speaking. He's dead in your face.
Yep. Yep.
But you guys can't hear it.
Hey, that's his spirit.
I got a quick precept to that real quick in Job 9 and 24. The earth is given into the hand of the wicked.
Mm-hmm. We already know who the wicked is. Wicked is Esau, Edom, the self-proclaimed white man
that's
ruling the earth. And the Lord gave him the rule to rule in his time so he can take him down.
Yep.
And that's the beauty of what we know to his remnant.
That's right.
And this is why the people of the earth are mourning, uproaring, protesting, languished, perplexed, because it's a wicked-ass heaven.
That's right.
And there's no escape.
Right. He covereth the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he?
Yep. And the judges of the earth is Yahweh Bashem El Shai. So they cover their faces back in the Renaissance era. They took down our paintings and put up their paintings.
Yep. And the people too, the Most High's chosen people, the Israelites, were the judges of the earth as well. Yep. And this devil put himself in our land talking about he's the chosen people.
Yep.
Covering us up with him.
Hey, the head judge himself, Yahweh. You see that old painting, was it Leonardo or Michelangelo, where he got him touching Adam? And they both look effeminate with his little ass rod and shit. That's supposed to be the Most High, man. Come on, man.
Heaven destruction to you, Esau. You got to pay for that, demon.
Hey, yep. you don't think the angels see that the angels painted as naked Edomite babies? Like, come on, man.
That's disgusting.
Nowhere in the scripture.
Right. And you know them little statues and the little so-called angels with the wings, little boys? That go back to a Latin word, puto, right? And that means homosexual youth.
So this devil's
trying to proclaim that the angels are sodomites, man. Wow. They're catamites.
That's why the Lord say he's gonna destroy this fucking demon like Sodom and Gomorrah. What are those pieces of shit was trying to do to the angels? They're trying to sleep with him.
Yeah.
Wow, man, he gotta come in, these motherfuckers through. Bugged out.
Alright, you hear the north, you call somebody a puto. And call you a faggot.
Hey, bundle of sticks, faggot.
And now, hey, are we not in the month? Are we not in the month of bundle of sticks?
Month of pride. That's a hell of a drug, man. Yeah. Y'all got a month for it, man.
Guess what? Pride goeth before destruction.
That's right.
That's it.
Yeah, I got a precept for brought out. This is Romans 8. I'm going to begin in verse 18. Romans 8, verse 18, it says, "For I reckon that the suffering of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory shall be revealed in us. For the earnest expectation of the creature," going into these other nations, "waited for the manifestation of the sons of the Most High," the elect. Alright, because see, they know, man, once we get the rulership, although they're gonna be under us, they're gonna eventually be in a better position.
Right. Right.
You know? So deep down in their spirit, they're waiting for righteousness to be reestablished on the earth, man. You know?
Well,